Hello everyone, let's move to our next concept, that is about 2D clipping. In the last video, I have explained you about what is 2D viewport, where we have discussed about what is window, what is viewport, and how whenever we are changing a window, we will be getting different options of seeing different parts of your image, and when the viewport is changed, we will be getting an option of seeing the same window at the different parts of our output device. And we also discussed how we can transform from window to viewport. Now let us see to the other concept, that is about 2D clipping. This 2D clipping talks about how to find, or it is a procedure of finding the part of an image, whether it is an interior or exterior to a specified region of space. So to do that, that concept is called as clipping, where it will be specifying if you have one area, in that area if you have an image, what part of that image will be interior, what part of that image will be exterior, that will be specified by using this clipping. And that area what we are selecting, that is called as clipping window. Now let us see how a point can be clipped and how a line can be clipped. So point clipping. Before the point clipping, I'll take one example. If this is your window, right? Now this is your clipping window. Now let me consider some examples. Right? Now by seeing this one, we can say this line is completely inside, interior to your clipping window. That means this will be visible, and this line will be completely exterior to your clipping window, so that this will be made invisible. But if you consider this way, that some part of your line will be interior and some part of your line will be exterior. That means we need to make from this point to this point visible, and this from this point to this point to be invisible. That is completely about wiki clipping concept. Now let us see what is point clipping. Point clipping is nothing but, if you take any point x1 and xy, how can we say that the point is inside your clipping window, and how can we say that point is out of your clipping window? So whenever you take any point xy, if the x coordinate values is less than or equal to in between your xv min and xv max, and the y coordinate value is in between yv min and yv max, then we say that the point is interior to your clipping window. And remember, whenever that point is on the boundary of the clipping window also, we will be considering that as your interior of your clipping window. Remember, the clipping window coordinates are xv min, smallest x value, xv max, the largest x value, yv min, the smallest y value, yv max, the largest y value. So your point, if it should be interior to your clipping window, it should possess these two characteristics. Okay, and if it is also on the border, that will be considered as your interior point. This is how the point clipping can be done. Let us see what is line clipping. Line clipping. Line clipping is nothing but, you will be having two endpoints. So we need to check the two endpoints position, and depending upon that, we need to say whether the line is completely interior, or whether the line is completely exterior, or the line is partially interior to your clipping window. So let us see the two cases. If the first case is, if the two endpoints are completely outside of your window, if the two endpoints are completely inside of your window, then we can say the line is interior to your clipping window. The case is like this. If the two endpoints are completely inside of your clipping window, then we can say the line is completely interior to your clipping window, and then we should make that line visible. The second case is, if the two points are completely exterior to your window, then we may not say like that line is completely exterior. Why? Because you have an option like this. If you observe, the two end points are completely exterior to your window, but we can't say, like, we can't make this line as invisible here, because this part is made as visible, and this part should be made invisible. So here comes a concept called finding the intersecting points. How that can be done, we'll see. This is one case, and the last case is where the two line end points here, where the two line end points are completely exterior, and in this case we should make this line invisible. So these are the three cases where the two end points will be completely interior, the two end points will be exterior. Then for exterior, if the line end points are completely exterior, we have two cases: the line will be crossing through the edges of your clipping window, or may not be crossing through the edges of your clipping window. If it is not crossing the edges of this clipping window, in this case you should make this line invisible, and in this case you need to find out the intersecting points, and we need to make this line visible. So how to do, we need to talk about all these cases. So to find the visible part of your line which is interior to your clipping window, we have two types of algorithms. So the first type of algorithm is Cohen-Sutherland algorithm. And the second algorithm is Cyrus-Beck line clipping algorithm. Both algorithms are used to perform the clipping only, line clipping only. So let us start with the Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm. So the first algorithm is Cohen-Sutherland line clipping. In this type of algorithm, for a clipping window, some region codes will be assigned, and depending upon that region codes, if you consider any line segment, for the line segment two endpoints will be there. For those two endpoints, we'll be assigning the region codes, right? And depending upon the region codes, we'll be identifying whether the line is completely interior, whether the line is completely exterior, or the line is partially interior or exterior. To do that, first we need to set region codes for that. So let us consider this is your clipping window. Okay, now for this clipping window, you will be having 8 options. You need to set 8 region codes. A clipping window will be given a region code of 4 zeros. Remember, here we need to assign 4 bit region codes. Okay, so when any line or the region code for the left side of this clipping window, if you consider B1, B2, B3, B4, a region code for the left side of your clipping window, the B1 bit will be 1. That means B1 bit will be 1, the other bits will be 0. Right? And the region code which is right side of your clipping window will be given a code of where this will be 1. That means second bit will be 1. This is 0, 1, 0, 0. Right? And the region code which is bottom to your clipping window will be given the third bit 1. That means you will have a value of 0, 0, 1, 0. And the region code which is top to your clipping window, where the fourth bit will be given 1. That means you will have a value of 0, 0. Now by using this, you can assign the values of these things also. If you consider this position, for this position, you can say it is left side bottom. Left side means you will have a bit value 1, and bottom means you will have a third bit also 1. So these two will be 0. If you consider this one, it is right side. Right side means second bit will be 1, and right side bottom means you will have a third bit also 1. So 1, 1, 0. If you consider this one, it is up. up means you have a bit 1 and it is right, you have a second bit also 1 and these two bits will be 0. If you consider this one, it is up left, left means first bit will be 1 and up means you will have a fourth bit 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0. This is how the region codes will be assigned depending upon your clipping window position. Now, whenever a line segment you consider, by using these bit codes, which are all bit codes are also called as region codes. Okay, using those region codes, we'll be checking, we'll be finding whether the line segment is interior, external, or partial. Now, whenever a line segment, the first case, whenever a line segment, if you consider the end points, both the end points are 0, 0, 0, 0, then we can say that line is completely interior. That means this case, if you consider. For this case, both the end points, if you consider, for both the end points, the region code is 0, 0, 0, 0. That means in that case, we need to say like the line is completely interior. We can say if P1 and P2, let us consider the points as P1 and P2. The region codes of P1 and P2 are 0, 0, 0, 0. Then it is completely interior to your clipping window and we can say it is visible. It should be made visible. Second case. If both the region codes of these points are non-zero, that means P1 and P2 both non-zero, in that case you need to find your logical AND operation. Okay, and if the output is also non-zero, after performing logical zero, if you are getting output is also non-zero, then we can say that line is completely exterior. Okay, and then we should make it as invisible. Let us take one example. Let us take P1 and P2 like this. Okay, P1 and P2 if you take like this, what is logical AND 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, you are getting 1, 0, 0, 0, which is non-zero. I said both should be non-zero and logical AND if you consider the value is also non-zero, then we should make the line is completely exterior to your clipping window. So this will be completely exterior to your clipping window, then we should make it invisible. Third case. What is the third case? The third case is, if one of the point is non-zero or if the logical AND is also non-zero. What are the two cases? You have two options here, A, B. If one of P1 and P2 is 0, or the second case, if both non-zero and logical AND is also non-zero, is also 0, both non-zero, but you will get a logical AND operation of 0, the reverse of this operation, in that case you need to find the intersecting point. So how to find that intersecting point? Let us talk about this third point, where you need to find the intersecting point. So how to find that intersecting point? Let us consider two points x1, y1 as here. We are talking about finding intersecting points. Okay. Let us consider a line segment x1, y1, x2, y2. And let us say this x1, y1, x2, y2 line segment is passing through your clipping window. That means you need to find the intersecting points. So let us consider that intersecting point which is xy. So let us find the slope of these two. What is the slope of these two? Y minus y1 by m equal to y minus y1 by x minus x1, which implies, I am finding the slope of these two, which implies y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1, which implies y equal to y plus 1 m into x minus x. Remember here x value will be, let us consider you are clipping like this. For y value, you are finding y value of vertical lines. Because for vertical lines, if you consider the value of y will be changing, but the value of x will be x min, x min for your left line and x max for your right line. So you have two options for x, where x equals to x min for left border and y and x equals to x max for your right border. Right? This is how you can find the y value of vertical lines. Now let us see how to find the x value of your vertical lines. X value of horizontal lines. So but again consider the same one, m equal to y minus y1 by x minus x1, which implies m into x minus x1 is equals to y minus y1, right? Which implies x minus x1 is equals to y minus y1 by m. And finally you will get x equals to x1 plus y minus y1 by m. Right? If you observe here the y value, you will have two options again. What are the two options? The y value for upper and lower. If you consider the x value will be same for this one and this one. But the y value will be changing. The y value will be y min for bottom border boundary. And y equal to y max for upper boundary. That means for this line the y value will be fixed. For this line the y value will be fixed. You need to find the x value. So by using these formulas we can find the intersecting point of your line segment. And from that intersecting point to the other line, you should make the line visible. This is how Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm will be. So let us see how this Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm can be worked by using an example. So we have derived Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm how to find out whenever a line is given whether it is interior or exterior or partially interior. So to do that, if the line is partially interior, we need to find out the intersecting points. We have derived these two formulas. That intersection point, if you are considering x, y, we have to use these formulas where while finding the x, this y value will be y min or y max, and this y, whenever you are finding this y value, this x value will be y min, x min or x max. Okay, now let us use that algorithm to find this. I am considering this line segment P1 and P2. I want to use that Cohen-Sutherland algorithm. So before proceeding, we need to set the region codes for P1 and P2. So what is the region code for P1? The region code for P1, we already decided. For the region code for this clipping window is 40, but if it is left side, the first bit will be 1. So as P1 is left to your clipping window, the first bit will be 1, the other bits will be 0. And the region code for P2. What is the region code for P2 is, I told you like for the above, the clipping, the region above the clipping width, the fourth bit will be 1 and the other bits will be 0. So the region code will be 1000. So we need to perform the logical end operation and we need to check after performing the logical end operation, the result is 0 or non-zero. If you apply logical end operation, here you can observe the value is 0. That means whenever the after performing logical end operation the value is 0, we can say like we need to find out the intersection point, that the line is partially inside your clipping window. To do that we need to find the intersecting points. Okay, so to find the intersecting points we need to consider some intersecting point. Let us consider this is your intersecting point x, y. Right? So let us the intersecting point is x, y. If you observe, For clipping window also, the lines are, the coordinates are given. By using those coordinates, we can say what is x, w, what is x, w, x we mean. Or clipping window we are saying, let us represent with w, x, w mean, x, w mean is always it is 50. X, w max it is always 80. Y, w mean is always, it is yw min it is always 10 and yw max it is equals to 40. Right, now we need to find the intersection point. What is the intersection point? I told you, like, we need to use these two formulas. So what is the formula used? Let us find out the y value first. Y equal to y1 plus m into x minus x1. Now what is y1? If we have, this is x1, y1. So what is y1? Our y1 is 50 plus, let us find out the slope first. Slope value m equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. So this will be our x2, y2. So what is slope value? 45 minus 15 by 75 minus 40. Okay, substitute this slope value here, m. Now what is this x? X value, if you observe here, we need to consider the x value as it is a left border, we need to consider x w mean. So what is x w mean? It is 50. 50 minus what is x1? X1 is your 40. Right? Now if you simplify this one, you will get a value of 23.563. That means then x, the intersecting point xy, we got it is, your x value will be always equals to xw means, which is equal to 50 comma 23.563. This is your first one. What is this one? 50 comma 23.563. That is rounded 23.5. Okay. Now we need to find out this intersecting point. Again, we need to follow the same procedure. What is that procedure? Let us consider, now let us designate this value with xy. For this xy, the y value is fixed. What is that y value? The y value is always 40. So we need to find the x value. So what is the formula used for x? X equal to x1 plus 1 by m into y minus y1. So what is x1 for this line? If you can, we can consider that one or this one, let us consider that one. That is 75 plus 1 by m into y value. Y, what is the y value we need to consider? When it is the upper y limit, so the y max we need to consider. Our y max is always 40. So let us consider the y max is 40 minus y1. What is the y1 value? Let us consider it is 45. Remember here, we are considering this point as x1, y1. Now if you simplify this one, you will get a value of 69.2. That implies you are getting the xy value for this one is 69.2 comma 40. So this point will be 69.2 comma 40. That means we need to make this part of your line visible and this part invisible and this part invisible. This is how Cohen-Sutherland line clipping algorithm will be done. If the both the lines are inside your clipping window, if you perform, if both are zero, then no need to perform the operation. If both are outside, if you perform logical end operation, that is also non-zero, no need to perform the operation. But when we need to find out the intersection point, only when after performing the logical end you will get the zero, then only we need to find the intersecting points and you need to proceed like this. This is how Cohen-Sutherland has given algorithm to find the line clipping. Thank you.